speed with getting everything organised when we came back in September to really get on to the Harvest Festival. But then we thought, actually, you know, we need to celebrate Harvest, and you'll see in my newsletter article that there was really good reasons why we should be celebrating Harvest and thanking God for His provision for us and all the goodness He gives us, and also celebrating those who've worked throughout this period of COVID and enabled us to continue to eat and so on. So that's one thing. So we've got Harvest today, and there are Harvest goods and they will go to Mission Trinity. Other than that, I started two things. I started a midweek YouTube service, which is a bit like the ones that we were having when we were locked down, but it's in the music's going to be generally more contemporary and the style's more contemporary. So it's more one style, which complements our Sunday mornings. And that should go out on Wednesdays. Last week it didn't go out because the computer went corrupt. And I also started a Zoom coffee, which there was just a few of us at last week, but it worked, you know. I think Zoom works best when you just sat there chatting. I don't know if you've had to do business on it, but when you've just got a small group of you chatting to one another on from your hands, it really seems to work quite well. And the aim is just to create a place that people can meet socially. And that's on a Thursday evening from 8 o'clock for about 40 minutes at the moment. And if we get a lot of people, we'll split them into smaller groups. It's going to be much easier. It's much better from a point of view of social interaction. Also, the magazine is going to make a comeback. There is, if you would prefer to receive your magazine electronically, it will save Kathy printing. So if anybody does want to receive it electronically as a PDF and you can read it that way, if you can tell Kathy, then we'll put together a list of people who receive it that way, and then we just don't have to print as many. I will still charge the same, hey. But it's the money normally goes towards the costs of it and the church funds and various things, so hopefully it all works out about that. The other thing is the sponsored walk has been completed. Thank you to a certain member at the back. And raised £2,100, so thanks to all those who are so generous towards that, so well done, that's fantastic. Right. We're going to have a Harvest Communion, and we're going to stand for the opening acclamation. It's from page 2 of our orders of service. We stand. Stand before the throne of God with countless crowds from every nation and race, tribe and language.
Blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor, power and might, be to our God forever and ever. Amen.
Turning to the creator of the universe, we pray.
Faithful one,
whose word is life,
come with saving power to free our graves, inspire our prayer, and shape our lives from the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
acted ungratefully. Hear our prayer and in your mercy, forgive us and help us. We enjoy the fruits of the harvest, but sometimes forget that you have given them to us. Father, in your mercy, forgive us and help us. We belong to a people who are full and satisfied, but can easily ignore the cry of the hungry. Father, in your mercy, forgive us and help us. We are often thoughtless and do not care enough for the world you have made. Father, in your mercy, forgive us and help us. We can store up goods for ourselves alone, as if there were no God and no heaven. Father, in your mercy, forgive us and help us. Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive you your sins, open your eyes to God's truth, strengthen you to do God's will, and give you the joy of his kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We won't do the Gloria. It's very easy to do the Peruvian Gloria without singing it, so we'll move on to the Collect. Eternal God, you crown the year of your goodness and give us the fruits of the earth in their season. Grant that we may use them to your glory, for our own well-being, and for the relief of those in need, through Jesus Christ your Son, our Lord. Amen. We sit for readings from the High.
Stand thus firm in the Lord, my beloved. magnanimity be manifest to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety, but in everything make your request known to God in prayer and petition with thanksgiving. Then the peace of God, which is beyond our utmost understanding, will keep guard over your hearts and your thoughts in Christ Jesus. And now, my friends, all that is true, all that is noble, all that is just and pure, all that is lovable and gracious, whatever is excellent and admirable, fill all your thoughts with these things. The lessons I taught you, the tradition I have passed on, all that you heard me say or saw me do, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. This is the word of the Lord.
Please stand for the gospel reading. Good news about Jesus is written in the Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 22nd chapter, beginning to read from the first verse. Hear the Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told them other parables. He said, "The kingdom of heaven can be illustrated by the story of a king who prepared a great wedding feast for his sons. When the banquet was ready, he sent his servants to notify those who were invited, but they all refused to come. So he sent other servants to tell them, 'The feast has been prepared, the bulls are fattened, and cattle have been killed, and everything is ready. Come to the banquet.' But the guests he invited ignored them and went their own way, one to his farm, another to his business. Others seized his messengers and assaulted them and killed them. The king was furious and he sent out his army to destroy the banquet and burn their town. And he said to his servants, 'The wedding feast is ready and the guests are invited aren't worthy of the honour. Now go out to the street corners and invite everyone you see.' So the servants brought everyone they could find, good and bad alike, and the banquet hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to meet the guests, he noticed the man wasn't wearing the proper clothes for a wedding. Friend, he asked, 'Who is it you are here without wedding clothes?' But the man made no reply. Then the king said to his aides, 'Find his clothes and throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen.' This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Yeah, the camera only lasts for 20 minutes, so I can only preach for 20. No, I've already done that joke. In the reading from Isaiah, we are reminded that the Lord is a tower of refuge to the poor and a tower of refuge to the needy in their distress. When we look at harvest, we often look locally, don't we? We often look around us and thank God for the harvest that has come into our setting and into our situation, for those who have worked locally to provide for us. And that's a good thing to do. It's a good thing to be grateful, and to be grateful for God's provision from our own land. But many of us eat the fruits of the labours of those who live in much poorer places than us. And many of those who bring in our harvest struggle in ways that we would never imagine are possible. And so it is important that we also, when we come to harvest, think not only locally, but think nationally and internationally. And think of those who have brought and worked for us, the poor and the needy, who sometimes struggle to provide for their own. And it's important when we go to the shops that we do think about things like fair trade and how we deal with these things. And it's always a balance, isn't it? Let's buy lots of things from the third world so that they get more money. Or let's not buy things from there, so that we go into the air miles. Yeah, there are challenges. There's things that we really have to think about in our response and our responsibility. may be that one of the ways that we can do these kind of things are not only to look to ourselves, but as we look at Christmas or other events, to look to organisations like Christian Aid and Tear Fund and so on, who do things to support people to make their own living where they are. And you might decide that, actually, I won't buy the stuff that's going to use all those air miles, but I could give a goat to somebody so that they can use that goat and use, and you can do that. You can join a scheme where you could decide to use some of that money that you would have spent on some of the things that are more exotic and just bought locally, so that we support local businesses and local ways, and then gave that money to those poor and needy through the projects that do exist to really make a difference to those who are struggling. And in the pictures that we often see in the Bible, the reality of their lives in the Bible, of starvation, of storms, of areas where when there wasn't enough rain, people were starving, are still very real to so many. And we need to be those who take our goodness, the great generosity that God has given to us, because we live in a fantastic place which has rain. I know that people do seem to complain, and I really can't understand why the television keeps saying it's a bad day when it rains. It really isn't a bad day when it rains. It's maybe not as easy to get out and enjoy yourselves in the sunshine, and it does feel nice and when the sun is out, but we need both, don't we? We live in a place flowing with milk and honey in many ways, and there are many across the world who do not live in that way, and we need to respond from the goodness that we have, from the fact that we have received so much through the richness of our land and through the way that our empire ran, and various things that we may actually question about their past and the way that we became rich. And we need to use our responsibility to be those who live as God wanted, in a way that brings hope. And that passage speaks of bringing hope and of challenging our bad practice and bad ways. And that's what the people of Israel were supposed to be, a people who did that. And it's what we, as the people of God, must continue to be. So we pray that as we thank God, we may also be reminded to be generous. Because for what we have received, we are truly thankful. And as we are truly thankful, the demonstration of that is us acting that out in making sure that we use the goodness of God not only for ourselves, but for those who are less well off and struggle in life. We pray that God may help us to do that effectively and well. Amen. Amen.
thank you for your presence here with us, for the incredible beauty and complexity of the natural world, its creatures, its seasons. Thank you that our bodies go on functioning with such ingenuity. And yet we seem to have misread the directions. Instead of taking care of this, your creation for us, we have, mostly in ignorance, used and abused the planet for our own greed and purposes. And now it is suffering. And so are all your creatures and all of us. It is not quite too late. Heavenly Father, we pray that all nations will do all that they can to halt the damage, repair the damage. If our leaders are reluctant to take the initiative, we pray that the children and young people whose world it will be will push our leaders to do all that, that should be done. We pray for success, for the success of such initiatives as the Earthshot Prize. Lord of life, in your mercy, hear us. Our bodies should function with such great ingenuity, but are threatened on all sides by dysfunction and disease, COVID-19 being among the most serious we've ever known. This produced so many problems beyond just the disease itself. We pray for those who have to judge the terrifying balancing act of disease versus economy, for the unemployed, those fearful for their businesses and jobs, for the isolated, the fearful, for those who are bored with it all. Heavenly Father, guide our future days through this extraordinary time. We know that you are with us. Lord of life, in your mercy, hear us. Thank you for the gifts of the season after the difficult year the farmers have had. They also face an uncertain future. And we pray for all farmers and producers and distributors. Let us take a few moments for silence to pray for all those affected in any way adversely at this time, and for ourselves in you.
Praise God.
placed us in the garden of your delight. Though we chose the path of rebellion, you would not abandon your own. Again and again, you drew us into your covenant of grace. You gave your people the law and taught us by your prophets to look for your reign of justice, mercy, and peace. As we watch for the signs of your kingdom on earth, we echo the song of the angels in heaven, evermore praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Lord God, you are the most holy one, enthroned in splendor and light. Yet, in the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, you reveal the power of your love, made perfect in our human weakness. Amen. Lord, we believe you. Embracing our humanity, Jesus showed us the way of salvation, loving us to the end. He gave himself to death for us, dying for his own. He set us free from the bonds of sin that we might rise and reign with him in glory. Amen. Lord, we believe. On the night he gave up himself for us all, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Amen. Lord, we believe. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Amen. Lord, we believe. Therefore we proclaim the death that he suffered on the cross. We celebrate his resurrection, his bursting from the tomb. We rejoice that he reigns at your right hand on high, and we long for his coming in glory. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. As we recall the one perfect sacrifice of our redemption, Father, by your Holy Spirit, may these gifts of your creation be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Form us into the likeness of Christ, and make us a perfect offering in your sight. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Look with favour upon all your people, and in your mercy hear the cry of our hearts. Bless the earth. Heal the sick. Let the oppressed go free. And fill your church with power from on high. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Gather your people from the ends of the earth to feast with all your saints at the table of your kingdom, where the new creation is brought to perfection in Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are all one, because we all share. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith, with thanksgiving. For the distribution of the communion, we will only receive the bread at this time because sharing of wine is complicated with coronavirus. But I will bring it to you where you are, if you could just hold out your hands, and I will wear a mask as I do so. If you'd like a prayer of blessing, please keep your hands down when I come to you. You in eternal life.
Amen.
praise and thank you, O Christ, for this sacred feast. For here we receive you. Here the memory of your passions renewed. Here our minds are filled with grace. And here a pledge of future glory is given, when we shall feast at that table, where you reign with all your saints forever. Amen. Together we pray. In darkness and in light, in trouble and in joy, help us, Heavenly Father, to trust your love, to serve your purpose, and to praise your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May God, who clothes the lilies and feeds the birds of the sky, who leads the lambs to pasture and the deer to water, who multiplied loaves and fishes and changed water into wine, lead us, feed us, multiply us, and change us to reflect the glory of our Creator, now and through all eternity. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and all whom you love, both now and evermore. Amen. I think it's hymn number 200, is that right? Yes. So we sit and sing in our heads hymn number 200.